up at Blairsville at my research vineyard, and we're actually doing a spray trial today. But these are Merlot grapes here, and we have Chardonnay grapes at the bottom of the hill as well. And this is a beautiful site to have a research vineyard up in the mountain area of Georgia. And a lot of diseases are up here. We have plenty to look at today, and I'll talk to you about a little of this. This just shows how we're spraying some of these grapes right now for this trial. Each of these plants is an individual replicate in a spray trial. And you can see the grapes hanging down, leaves, but we're covering this for powdery mildew. Yet I know I'll make you sick moving up and down this plant, trying to look at all this powdery mildew. But the degree to which this takes over a European grape plant is just pretty amazing. It does not have resistance to it. Obviously, European grapes were not originally developed in the presence of powdery mildew, which was a new world pathogen. And this lack of resistance is just really impressive. You can imagine if you were in Europe in the mid-1800s and this came into your grapes, started doing this kind of damage, you'd be sick. You'd lose your profession, lose your ability to produce your product. And for those 2 or 3 years before people actually figured out what to do, the losses were tremendous. Lots of money went into it. There were prizes given to people who could find the answers to how to solve the problem. It's not in the same level as what you would see with something like a coronavirus, but for a plant, this was more widespread and more devastating. So here's a nice, if you want to call it nice, powdery mildew example. You can see all the white kind of blotches on this that's starting to show up on this particular leaf. So this is pretty extensive. This is the most powdery mildew I've seen today on any leaf, and so there's a good bit there. And what I wanted to use this for, though, is to actually show you a little bit closer. If I go through a hand lens here, and I'll get in here, we'll look at some of this as well, the powdery mildew, you're going to see this kind of look here. It almost looks like pubescence or hairs growing on the leaf itself, but you can see how that's blotchy. And that's actually more or less what you're going to be seeing with the powdery mildew through a hand lens, because that's what I'm using. So it doesn't get, that's a pretty good shot of it right there. Again, this is on the top of the leaf. If you go to underside of the leaf, you're not going to see that at all. But that's all the powdery mildew starting to move out through that leaf and starting to sporulate a little bit here also. You can see the where this is starting to happen. But anyway, that's what you'd expect to see through a hand lens. Not very showy, not as easy to identify as downy mildew, but that's just a good opportunity to show you that. Sometimes you'll actually see the chasmathesia, maybe a little bit early this time of year to start picking those up. But those would look like, at some points, like gumdrops, but they turn black eventually. And the chasmathesia would also be present. And you can kind of get a feel for what this looks like. Again, looking through a hand lens.